So hello everyone, my name is Mark and welcome to a new FIFA 21 video on my channel. In this video, I'm gonna check out what the drop between the defender instruction for the central defensive midfielder exactly is doing. I'm gonna do that in an offline match against the AI. As you can see here, we're playing against West Bromwich Albion with amateur AI, but that is not really the point. We are playing with Liverpool and I'm going to show you the formation that I'm doing in the 4-3-3 holding, or the 4-3-3 false number 9 it is. I just did everything on balanced for the tactics, and the only thing that I changed for now is Fabinho is playing the central defensive midfielder, drop between the defenders, and what I did is stay back while attacking for the fullbacks. And then I'm gonna play the match. I'm gonna show you what Fabinho is exactly doing and what the players around him are doing. And then I'm gonna switch the fullbacks to offensive. I'm gonna switch the tactics a bit. So we're gonna see what difference that make to this this instruction, because this is an instruction it was introduced in FIFA 20, and I think they changed the working of this instruction a few times, because sometimes I'm having the idea that he is really dropping back between the defenders, sometimes he's not. So I wanted to know what it exactly does, and I also got a comment from one of you viewers to check it out. So, and I thought, well, that's pretty interesting, let's check it out. But before we begin, I really want to ask you to drop a like under the video. I would really appreciate it if you will do that. And if you're new to my channel, make sure you will hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any new videos I'm posting. I'm doing lots of tutorial videos like this. I'm doing tactic videos, so best tactics to play with specific teams. So if you're interested in that, make sure you hit that subscribe button, and then we are going to begin right now. All right, and there we are, kickoff against West Bromwich Albion. And what I'm doing is just playing the ball back to the goalkeeper. And you see Fabinho is just between the center backs, and the fullbacks are just here. So we have lots of players here to pass the ball around and set up the attack really easy. And then let's see what Fabinho is going to do when we are going forward. He is out of the screen now. And now he's coming forward a bit, but not that much. You should expect that when you are attacking that he will come forward also, but he is not doing that. All right, so that's what we know now. Now, when we lose the ball, he's coming forward and he's going into the midfield again. All right, what I'm gonna do now, same situation, Alisson has the ball. What I'm gonna do now is change the fullbacks to join the attack. Let's see what difference it makes. So, fullbacks join the attack. So, as you can see, they are going forward a bit now, fullbacks. But Fabinho is still here. Between the defenders. And as you can see, Van Dijk. Oh, I'm losing the ball now here. But Van Dijk and Gomez are wider because the fullbacks are going forward, in my opinion. They are a bit wider than they were before. Alright, what I'm gonna do now is change the tactics to fast build-up. And what we know from fast build-up is that everybody is going forward. Especially the fullbacks now, they have joined the attack. As you can see on the radar, Trent Alexander-Arnold is really high on the pitch. Robertson is really high on the pitch. And Van Dijk is even wider than he was before. And Fabinho is the central one. So you have an extra man to play the ball around here in the mid, on the back, because if he was not dropping back, he would be farther, further on the pitch, higher on the pitch, and then you only have Van Dijk and Gomez to play the ball around. As you can see, Gomez is really on the side of the field, on the right side, and this was an awful pass for me. And when you lose the ball, they are going back to the middle. And there you can see how wide the center backs are, and Fabinho is in the middle. All right, what I'm gonna do now, exact same situation, but no drop back for Fabinho. So, balanced attack for Fabinho. Let's see what he is going to do now. Oh, we need to be careful there. So Fabinho is running a bit forward and Van Dijk is coming into the center of the field. And Gomez is coming into the center. And now you have only two players on the back. Because as you can see where Robertson is, he's already on the middle line. And also Trent Alexander-Arnold is really high on the pitch. So it's getting harder to play the ball around. When Fabinho is not dropping back between the defenders. So let's see it again. As you can see on the radar, Gomez and Van Dijk are in the middle now, where they're supposed to be. Not that wide anymore. And now you can play the ball around between Gomez and Van Dijk. And when your opponent shoots press really high on the pitch, you have a difficult time to play the ball around. Alright, now I'm gonna see what it does when the instructions for the fullbacks are just back on stay back while attacking, and then we have a normal situation, I think. Just four guys on the back, Fabinho a bit higher. Robertson is already back. There he is. And now you have the normal situation. Two center backs, a right and a left defender, Fabinho in front of them. So you can play the ball around. Alright, so that's pretty good to know. But this is a good instruction when you are playing fast build-up with attacking fullbacks. In my opinion, that's the best reason to use this instruction. So again, join the attack for the fullbacks and then Fabinho drop between the defenders and the tactics. Fast build-up, and what you see what he is doing, he's dropping back between the defenders, and then you have Gomez on the right side. You have Van Dijk, as you can see here, who's really left on the pitch. On the left side, Gomez on the right side, Fabinho between them, and the fullbacks are going forward. So you have an extra option to play the ball around. And yeah, that's it. That's, in my opinion, the only reason why you should use the drop between the defenders. Because if you are just playing a normal tactic with fullbacks who are staying back, it's not really useful to use drop between the defenders. But when the fullbacks are going to attack and you are playing fast build-up, it's really useful to put Fabinho in this case, or your other central defensive midfielder, drop between the defenders. So you have three guys on the back to play the ball around and set up your attack. So in my opinion, that's the way how you should use this. All right, hopefully you learned something from this video, because that's why I'm making these videos. I learned for myself, of course, and I try to learn you how this game and all the instructions and all the tactics that you can use, how they work. So hopefully you learned something from it, and hopefully we will see you next time. Have a great day. Bye-bye.